Cyprus, the Greek economy, and the theological school of Halki in Turkey, all addressed this evening by Vice President Biden here at the 42nd biannual clergy laity meeting in Philadelphia.
The tone of the evening was both serious and positive as the clergy and laity listened to the words of Vice President Biden. Some 1,500 attendees from across North America gathered for this gala that touched on these themes and the reconstruction of the St. Nicholas National Shrine at Ground Zero.
Απόψε ήταν μια συγκλονιστική βραδιά. Κλείνει το 42ο συνέδριο της κληρικολαϊκής, μιας μεγάλης πραγματικά και πολύ σημαντικής εκδήλωσης της ελληνοορθόδοξης κοινότητας. Εγώ προσωπικά έμεινα βαθιά εντυπωσιασμένος από τον παλμό, την παρουσία του κόσμου. Είναι εδώ πάνω από 1.500 άτομα. Η ηγεσία της ελληνοορθόδοξης εκκλησίας με επικεφαλής τον Σεβασμιότατο Αρχιεπίσκοπο κύριο Δημήτριο. Αλλά εκείνο που νομίζω ότι έκλεψε την παράσταση, θα μου επιτρέψετε την έκφραση, είναι η συγκλονιστική παρουσία του Αντιπροέδρου των ΗΠΑ, του κ. Biden, ο οποίος σε μια πολύ συγκροτημένη ομιλία του αναφέρθηκε σε τρεις μεγάλες ενότητες, στα φιλικά αισθήματα που τρέφει ο ίδιος προσωπικά, αλλά και η administration για την Ελλάδα, τις ενέργειες που κάνουν για να βοηθήσουν τη φίλη Ελλάδα να ξεπεράσει την φοβερή οικονομική κρίση την οποία διερχόμαστε. Μίλησε για το Πατριαρχείο, το Οικουμενικό και τις προσπάθειες που κάνει η Αμερική να βοηθήσει ώστε η Τουρκία να ανταποκριθεί σε στοιχειώδεις υποχρεώσεις έναντι του Οικουμενικού Πατριαρχείου και ασφαλώς το μεγαλύτερο τμήμα της παρουσίασης του κυρίου Biden αφιερώθηκε στην Κύπρο, όπου όπως έτσι και προσωπική συμβολή στην τελευταία προσπάθεια που γίνεται ούτως ώστε να βρεθεί κάποια λύση φέτος, ιδίως που συμπληρώνονται τα 40 χρόνια από την τραγική εισβολή της Τουρκίας.
Well, I was thrilled to hear him speak, especially that he was so supportive of the Ecumenical Patriarch. As you must have noticed, that was a resounding response from the audience when they heard of his support and his passion about it, and of course his love for his All Holiness really came out. So I was thrilled with his speech.
What did you think about the week here in Philadelphia? How did it go?
Amazing. Are you kidding? Michael and I are amazed. We have all fabulous feedback. I just think it couldn't have gone better. And we really had a great group of delegates this year. I mean, supportive and eager to learn, eager to find new ways to help their churches. So we were really thrilled.
When the vice president mentioned his three points, in my opinion, point number two, when he addressed religious freedom, which drew a thunderous standing O, he hit a home run. He alluded to the basic human right of practicing your own religion without being persecuted or discriminated against, and which we take for granted as Americans. However, as was mentioned in the Archon report, we're in the minority in this world. Perhaps only 30% of the world enjoys religious freedom. And this is a most important thing for the Archons, for the church in America, for the rest of the world.
Anthony?
Yeah, I thought Vice President Biden hit a grand slam, to take the analogy of my brother. You know, he spent several hours at the Ecumenical Patriarchate a couple of years ago. It affected him. He is very familiar with all the issues, including the interference in the election of the Ecumenical Patriarch, the confiscation of properties by the Turkish government, the closure of Halki. All these things he knows, one, two, three, four. And he's brought them up. We're all frustrated that there has been little progress. It's 43 years that Halki is closed. It's outrageous. And this persecution not only is in Turkey, but it's throughout the whole Middle East. And when we talk about Christian persecution in the Middle East, two-thirds of the Christians in the Middle East are Orthodox. So when you talk about Christian persecution in the Middle East, you're talking about Orthodox persecution in the Middle East. beheadings, crucifixions, executions. These things are happening.
You know, this evening I'm quite impressed. First of all, to have the Vice President of the United States address the 42nd biannual Greek Orthodox Archdiocese clergy lady. He spoke about religious freedoms in Turkey. He wants to see, and he thinks that he's being very, very optimistic that we'll see the Halki Seminary open very soon. He spoke about Greece and its economy, and he thinks it's turning the bend. He feels that it's turning a bend. And finally, he spoke very intimately about Cyprus, about his recent trip there with his wife, and how he made no point, he had no excuse that he was going to make sure that he made the point that the United States was very, very supportive of making Cyprus one government, making sure there was only one government that was recognized in Cyprus. And I thought that was special. But then finally at the end, he asked for the prayers of the Greek Orthodox Church to do so. So I was quite impressed with him being here this evening. I think it's, whether you're Democrat, whether you're Republican, the fact that the second, you know, leader in command of our country is here in front of the Archdiocese, in front of the clergy and lady of America, to share his insight and to ask for the prayers of our clergy and our laity so that things can become one again in Cyprus. I mean, 40 years ago, coming up very, very soon, 40 years ago in July, something that he said was uncouth, something that should never have happened. And he's fought that battle as the chairman of the Foreign Affairs Committee in the Senate to today as Vice President of the United States. So I was impressed. He had some great optimism in his words. And again, I was impressed.
Well, it's wonderful to be here again in Philadelphia, where tonight we celebrate, obviously, the life of our church via the clergy lady that takes place every 2 years. As I understand it, there's going to be a record turnout here tonight. And of course, we're very privileged to have the Vice President of the United States, who of course comes from nearby Delaware. We expect all good things from the Vice President. I've certainly have had the opportunity to meet with him twice during the last 6 weeks regarding Cyprus. They were off the record, unfortunately, so I can't give you what he said. What I can say is that he is a friend of the Greek-American community. He is a friend of Cyprus. And I expect him to resonate that sentiment here tonight.
Είμαι πολύ περήφανος και συγκινημένος που το clergy lady γίνεται εδώ στη Φιλαδέλφεια, σε αυτή την πόλη που είμαστε όλοι και κάνουμε δουλειά. Είναι η πρώτη φορά που παρακολουθώ clergy lady και εύχομαι όλα να πάνε καλά και η συνεδρίαση αυτή, το Congress, να ήταν καλό και αποδοτικό. Είμαι πολύ ευχαριστημένος επίσης με όλη την οργάνωση και που έχω δει και επίσης με τον Μητροπολίτη μας, τον κύριο Ευάγγελο, που έχει καταφέρει να μαζέψει όλη αυτή την κοινότητα, την Αμερικάνικη, σε national level, να τους μαζέψει εδώ πέρα και να τους φιλοξενήσει τόσο καλά μαζί με την Αρχιεπισκοπή.
This weekend was something undescribable. It was so beautiful to see our Greek Orthodox community come together and welcome our brethren from all over the country here to Philadelphia. It was a very proud moment for us. We got to meet a lot of people from all over the country, and we hope they got an opportunity to enjoy what Philadelphia has to offer.
And tonight's gala event with President Biden, what are your feelings as you stand by and wait to enter the doors and see him speak?
Well, today is a culmination of a whole week's worth of events, and we're certainly very happy to see that our political representatives are showing support for our Greek Orthodox community here in Philadelphia for the 42nd Biannual Clergy Lady Congress.
Well, this has been a blessed week, I must say. So much has transpired. Seeing all of the archdiocese come together like this has been a moving experience. Tonight, of course, is the highlight of the weekend, of the week. The grand banquet with the presence of the Vice President of the United States, Joe Biden, a sign that the Greek-American community plays a great role in the life of this country, this blessed country.
Thank you, Terry. Thank you, Philly, Cosmos Philly, for the outstanding support throughout the year. This was the greatest event that the Greek community in Philadelphia has seen in many years, the Clergy Lady Congress. It was unbelievable. It was a very successful event that started Sunday at the Church of the Cathedral of St. George. The Federation of Hellenic Societies offer all the help that it was possible to His Eminence, our beloved Metropolitan Evangelos of New Jersey, with the purpose of supporting anything that it had to do with the Clergy Lady to make it a great success. We hope that the waterworks, we hope that the church, and tonight, the final night, the best night, we're here to support again our metropolis and the Archdiocese of America. Thank you.